July 8th, Daily Video Bible Reading from the Net Bible, 2 Corinthians chapter 3 of the New Testament. Are we beginning to commend ourselves again? We don't need letters of recommendation to you or from you as some other people do we? You yourselves are our letter, written on our hearts, known and read by everyone, revealing that you are a letter of Christ delivered by us, written not with ink, but by the Spirit of the living God, not on stone tablets, but on tablets of human hearts. Now we have such confidence in God through Christ. Not that we are adequate in ourselves to consider anything as if it were coming from ourselves, but our adequacy is from God, who made us adequate to be servants of a new covenant, not based on the letter, but on the Spirit. For the letter kills, but the Spirit gives life. But if the ministry that produced death, carved in letters on stone tablets, came with glory, so that the Israelites could not keep their eyes fixed on the face of Moses because of the glory of his face, a glory which was made ineffective, how much more glorious will the ministry of the Spirit be? For if there was glory in the ministry that produced condemnation, how much more does the ministry that produces righteousness excel in glory? For indeed, what had been glorious now has no glory because of the tremendously greater glory of what replaced it. For if what was made ineffective came with glory, how much more has what remains come in glory? Therefore, since we have such a hope, we behave with great boldness, and not like Moses, who used to put a veil over his face to keep the Israelites from staring at the result of the glory that was made ineffective. But their minds were closed, for to this very day the same veil remains when they hear the old covenant read. It has not been removed, because only in Christ is it taken away. But until this very day, whenever Moses is read, a veil lies over their minds. But when one turns to the Lord, the veil is removed. Now the Lord is the Spirit, and where the Spirit of the Lord is present, there is freedom. And we all, with unveiled faces reflecting the glory of the Lord, are being transformed into the same image from one degree of glory to another, which is from the Lord, who is the Spirit. God, I was thinking about verse 9, where it says, For if there was glory in the ministry that produced condemnation, how much more does the ministry that produces righteousness excel in glory? And talking about the Old Covenant, the stories in the Old Testament, this reference to Moses. And I was just thinking about it that we very much take for granted that we have the New Covenant. We have a relationship that produces righteousness, that has forgiveness built within that relationship. I just keep going back thinking about the Old Testament stories and how they must have never really felt sure if they were forgiven of their sins. You know, they just felt like they had to sacrifice just one more animal and one more thing of oil and one more everything in order to cleanse themselves. And so people who were seeking you, God, that must have been like an incredibly frustrating thing for them to never truly know, were they forgiven? Were they in a relationship with you? Were they going to heaven? And especially when they saw discipline happen, right? So they would see people or whole families swallowed up, killed on the spot for doing something bad. And they must have just constantly lived in this fear of thinking that they can't do anything because it will probably be wrong. And then here we are. We have this amazing new covenant through your Son that includes grace and mercy and forgiveness and definitely love. And it's not that you're not the God of the Old Testament now. I still am disciplined. I've still seen your wrath. I'm still very much in fear of you. that I have this hope. I have this freedom. I have an opportunity to know that my sins, without question, are forgiven through repentance. I know I can be in a relationship with you. I know that I get to spend eternity with you in heaven. Those are all things I know with the new covenant. God, my thanks will never be sufficient for sending your Son to give us hope, to give us freedom, to give us forgiveness and eternal life. What I could come up with to say would never be sufficient. But I pray that my life and my actions and my heart, that you are pleased with those. That my daily walk with you and my reflection of who you are to others, that you are pleased with that. God, continue to work in me. Help me to remove anything that doesn't need to be there and shouldn't be there in my life and in my heart. And everything that is good, and it's good because of you, God. Allow it to not only stay there, but grow stronger and bigger for your will and for your glory. God, I never want to take for granted this amazing gift that's been given to me of the forgiveness of my sins. I never want to take for granted the grace and mercy and love that you have given me. I want to always grow in a relationship with you and be excited about new things and love learning new opportunities to talk to others about you, God. In Moses' time, the glory faded from his face, just like the old covenant was fading away and being replaced with the new covenant. But God, I never want my excitement and joy and desire to please you to ever go away, to ever fade. In your Son's name I pray. Amen.